In this video, we are continuing with intersecting chords and tangents. Here, he's saying that if AB and CD are two chords, AB and CD are two chords of a circle, which when produced meet at point P, right? So here the chords are meeting externally at point P outside the circle, such that PA is 12 centimeters. So PA is 12 centimeters. AB, length of AB is 4 centimeters. And CD, length of CD is 10 centimeters. He wants us to calculate the length of PD. Now, we know that when two chords intersect internally or externally, then the product of their segments is equal, right? So how do we write this? We will write this as PA into PB is equal to PC into PD. P should be there. So this is by theorem. And what is the theorem? When two chords intersect each other internally or externally, then the product of their segments is same, equal, right? Now he wants us to calculate this PD, right? Let's keep this PD as X. So PA, do we have PA? Yes, we have PA as 12 centimeters. Now do we have PB? No, we don't have PB. But yes, we have AB. We can calculate PB. How? AP minus AB. So we can calculate PB as AP minus AB. Right? So what is my AP? AP is 12. And what is my AB? 4, which is 8 centimeters. So I can write PB as 8 centimeters here. PC, do I have PC? No, I don't have PC, but yes, I have CD as 10 centimeters. He has given CD as 10 centimeters. So how do we write this PC? I can write PC as 10 plus X into PD as X. Now, this has become a quadratic equation in X. So I will solve it. So X squared plus 10X minus 96 equal to 0. I will split the middle term. So 16 into 6 is 96. 16 minus 6 is 10. So X square plus 16X minus 6X minus 96 equal to 0. So if I take X common here, I'll get X plus 16. If I take minus 6 common here, X minus 16 equal to 0. So finally, I have X minus 6 and X, sorry, this is plus. X plus 16 equal to 0. So what are your two values for X? They are 6 and minus 16, but you are going to reject this value because length can never be negative. So your X is 16 centimeters. So you have found your PD as 6 centimeters. Right? Okay. Now, another sum. He's saying that in the given figure, two circles intersect each other at the points A and B. So they touch each other at these two points, A and B. If PQ and PR are tangents to these circles. Now PQ and PR are the tangents and the point of contacts are Q and R. From a point P on BA produced. So P is lying on the line BA produced, show that PQ is equal to PR. Okay, all right. Now let's for some time forget the smaller circle and you look at this circle. In this circle, AB is a chord, right? And if you extend this chord to this point P, then from P you have PQ as a tangent. Isn't this situation like this? You have a tangent and a chord. This is your P, this is your A, B, and this is your Q. And we know the theorem that when the chord and the tangent, this is the chord to this big circle, AB is the chord to big circle. So when the chord and the tangent intersect externally at a point, then the product of the segments of chord is equal to the square of the length of the tangent. So can I write here PQ square is equal to PA into PB, those are the segments of the chord, PA into PB. So this is by theorem, right? So name this one equation. Now forget the big circle, come to this smaller circle. In this smaller circle, PR is the tangent and AB is the chord, and this tangent and this chord intersect externally at this point. Again, we have the same situation. So can we write PR square equal to PA into PB? This is my second equation, and by theorem, if you compare these two, PQ square is equal to PA into PB. PR square is also equal to PA into PB. So when you compare first and second, comparing first and second, you get PR square is equal to PQ square. Now you can take square root on both sides, then you will get PR is equal to PQ. That's what you had to find. Now, we have another situation, and we are given a figure in which AB is the direct common tangent to these two intersecting circles. We have two intersecting circles and they are intersecting at point C and point D. And AB is the direct common tangent to this, right? Their common chord when produced, now CD is their common chord. When you produce this common chord, it meets this tangent at point P. Now you have to prove that P is the midpoint of AB, or in other words, you have to prove that AP is equal to PB, right? We'll take the same situation that we did in the that we took in the previous question. We'll take this circle and forget about the smaller circle. In this, CD is a chord which you have extended to this point P, and from P you have PA as the tangent. So can I write that length square of the length of the tangent is equal to the product of the segments of PC into PD, products of the segments of chord. So this is my first equation, and this is by theorem. So in board examination, you should write the entire theorem. Similarly, now come back to this circle, smaller circle. PB is the tangent and CD is the chord. And when you extend the chord, the tangent and the chord meets at point P. So you can write that PB square is equal to PC into PD. This is your second equation. This is also by theorem. Now, PA square is equal to PC into PD. PB square is also equal to PC into PD. So if you compare these two equations, comparing first and second, you are getting PA square equals to PB square. Now, if you take the square root on both sides, you will get PA equal to PB. When is PA equal to PB? Only in one situation, if P is the midpoint of AB. So you have proved that, therefore, P is the midpoint of AB. So when you have to write it like this, when you have to prove this statement, you should write in the board examination at the end. All right. Now let's come to this question. In this question, we have a figure. Okay. This is the figure. PAT is a tangent. Okay. This is PA and this is T. PAT is a tangent at A. At A means A is the point of contact. If angle ACB, this angle is given 50 degrees, you have to find angle TAB and also this angle ADB. ADB. Now we know the theorem, and the theorem that we are going to use here is called the angle in the alternate segment. We know that the angle between the chord and the tangent through the point of contact is equal to the angle in the alternate segment. What does that mean? AB is a chord and PT is the tangent, A is the point of contact. So angle between this tangent and chord is equal to the angle made by this chord in the opposite direction. And what is that? 50. So can I say that angle TAB is equal to 50 degree? Reason, angle in the alternate segment. See, if you are well versed with these theorems, these questions will become easy for you. You need to know this theorem. Okay, now this angle you have found, TAB you have found. Now you are going to find ADB. Very simple. If you look at this figure, ADBC, is it a cyclic quadrilateral? Yes. Why? Because all its endpoints are lying on the circumference of the circle. And we know the property of the cyclic quadrilateral, that opposite angles are supplementary. That is, their sum is supplementary. So can I write ADBC? This order also you have to maintain. If you are writing A, then you should not write B. After A is D, B, C. ADBC is a cyclic quadrilateral. Therefore, angle ACB plus angle ADB is equal to 180. Here you can write the reason: opposite angles of cyclic quadrilateral are supplementary. Right? This means that all these reasons you have to write in the board examination. Now this you know, this is 50 plus angle ADB equal to 180. So you get your angle ADB as 180 minus 50, which is 130 degrees.